In this video, we will show the Polymath program that solved the problem that is presented in another screencast. This is the ethanol processing in the body, essentially, and how ethanol goes in the GI tract into the bloodstream, and then it decomposes in the bloodstream. And we could create a simplified model in which we have a mass balance for the GI tract where we're feeding methanol in and then we're removing it in the first order process into the bloodstream. And in the bloodstream, we have a term where we're adding ethanol from the GI tract and then we decompose into byproducts in a zero order reaction. And then this particular mass balance, we have initial conditions, and we have one slight difference from other type problems in that this rate that methanol is being fed is only for the first 2 hours. Someone is consuming at a uniform rate ethanol for 2 hours and then they stop drinking the ethanol. And so we're going to put these equations then into a Polymath program. And what we'll show you here is how to input the equations into a Polymath program. So I've opened Polymath. I'm going to then go to the program, differential equations, and I'm going to then start by entering a new differential equation. So for this tab, entering a new differential equation, and first I'll put in the one for the concentration in the GI tract where my independent variable is time, and then the balance is a feed rate entering, and then I have this first order reaction, if you like, a first order process, not really reaction, where the concentration in the GI tract determines how fast it moves into the bloodstream. So there's a negative sign here because we're removing the ethanol from the GI tract, and initially we start out with no ethanol in the system. So I could put a comment in here that this is ethanol in the GI tract. Now, I can then add the second differential equation the same way, where now it's the concentration in the blood. Again, it starts out at zero, and the equation now is that we first have K1, R concentration, the GI tract, so the first order process, it absorbs, and then we remove it in a zero order reaction. And so again, a comment, this is ethanol concentration in the blood. So we have the two reactions and the initial conditions. We can now put in our rate constants. K1 is equal to 10. K0 is equal to 0.2. A couple more things we want to do. We want an initial value of time to be 0. That's when we start. And we'll do the integration for 12 hours. Only thing left now to enter is the feed rate. You notice this arrow is not highlighted, meaning we're not able yet. And if we were to hit this, it will say we have this undefined variable. And so now we're going to use the feed rate. We're going to use an if statement saying if the time is less than 2 hours, then feed rate is equal to 2.0. That's the value from our original problem. Else, the feed rate is 0. So this expression accounts for the fact that for the first 2 hours, a person is consuming ethanol at a constant rate, and then they stop after 2 hours, so no additional ethanol is being fed in. So we want the equation to be integrated from 0 to 2 hours with a value of 2 here, integrated a longer time with a value of 0. Now you'll notice that the arrow is highlighted, meaning that the problem is completely specified and we can solve it. Let's select here that we want a graph rather than a report. It now has integrated and displayed a graph. And so if I hit the button that converts it so I can see all the windows, then I can see this is the concentration in the GI tract. It quickly gets up to almost a constant value before dropping off. This is the concentration in the bloodstream. If I right click here, I can format. For example, I can put a title of ethanol concentration. I can also modify the format. For example, I can have the x-axis have one decimal place rather than scientific notation. Likewise for the y-axis, I can change the font sizes. Let's make them 12. So they're much bigger, easier to see. I can also change the scale that I'm plotting if I want to. I can make the curves stand out a little more by making them thicker. And so we have a display for the concentrations, and of course I can move this out of the way so I can see the plots. So I can print this or save this. I can generate easily other curves for different conditions. I can integrate to longer time so all the ethanol is out of the bloodstream. And then I should, of course, save this Polymath file as ethanol concentration. And so this shows how to use a Polymath program. It's a semi-batch reactor, and we've shown how to put an if-then statement into solving your differential equations.